Hello friends, today I am taking unit 3 of estimation and costing of 5th sem. It is estimation in machine shop. Generally, it is what we are asked to find is the time, estimate the time required to finish a particular job. A job will be given and we will be asked to find out what is the time likely to be taken to finish the job from the raw material. Now, in machine shop, we use machine tools. Machine tools are the machines which remove the excess material in the form of chips. They are all called as machine tools. Like we have lathe, drilling machine, then we have milling machines. Then grinding machines, etc. So the problem, generally one problem will be there from this, one problem will be always there from lathe, and from these there may be one more problem, or sometimes only one problem will be there which will be on lathe. And what we have to estimate is, as I said, in all this thing, it is the time. Now, what are the operations that can be carried out? First, we'll take up lathe, which is the most important machine here in a machine shop. Now, the operations which can be done on a lathe machine. Operations which can be performed on a lathe machine. Now, these are some of the operations that can be made: facing, plane turning, then step turning, taper turning. Then you have drilling. You can do drilling also in this thing. Boring. Boring. Reaming. Etc. Then the last one, I'll take thread cutting. Now, except for thread cutting, for all other operations, we use only one formula. We get only one formula, which is T is equal to L divided by F into N. L by F into N, so many minutes per cut. T is the time taken to finish one cut in minutes. Here, L means the length of tool travel. The length of tool travel, that is the length to which that particular operation you are moving the tool during that operation, that is L. F is called feed per revolution. Now, these two must be in the same unit, that is, they may be both in centimeter or both in millimeter. these two, they are linear dimensions. Now, n means speed in RPM. Speed in RPM. Speed at which the job is rotated in the machine in RPM. Now, feed means, suppose this is the job we are turning. Feed means how much the tool, cutting tool, moves in this direction. You know, normally we move from the right to the left. How much it moves in one revolution, per revolution of the job, how much the tool is moving this way, that is called as the feed per revolution. It can be given either in millimeter or in centimeter. Now, this and this both should be in the same unit. This n will not be directly given. They will say for different operations, they will give s. S stands for cutting speed. Cutting speed in meters per minute. Meters per minute. Now, from this, we will have to find out this n. This cutting speed will be equal to pi dn, pi dn. Here, both s and d should be in the unit, in the same unit. So, if s is generally in meters per minute, it depends upon the operation. For different operation, the cutting speed will be different. This will be given in meters per minute. So, here, d is dia of job. Dia of the job in meter. In meter, n is the RPM. If you know d is this, if this is the job, this is the dia of the job, then if we know s and d, we can get n from here. That n must be substituted here to get it. If you are going to do it in a number of cuts, then you have to multiply it by number of cuts. Now, how many cuts we have to do depends upon the depth of cut. Now, depth of cut means in one cut, how much this tool, how much it will penetrate into the job, or what is the depth, this, what is the thickness of the material that we are going to remove in one cut. Now, the reduction in diameter, will be equal to 2 into depth of cut, because when you give a cut here, because it is rotating, this side also it will be reduced by the same this thing. 2 into depth of cut is the reduction. Now, the number of cuts will be equal to, number of cuts required will be equal to initial dia of the job, initial dia minus the final dia. That is, to what dia you want to reduce it, from which dia to what dia you want to reduce, divided by 2 into depth of cut will give you the number of cuts. If you get it as a fraction, say 1 point something, you will take it as 2. If it is 2 point something, we will take it as 3. If it is 3 point something, we have to take it as 4. So, this formula basically, in lathe, in all operations of lathe, this is the formula which we use to find it, except for thread cutting. If it is threading, then the formula will slightly change. For thread cutting, the equation is T will be equal to L, that is length of the threads, plus over travel, because there will be some over travel. It cannot be started exactly at the point where the thread start, and it cannot end at the end. So there will be a slight over travel divided by pitch of threads we are cutting into n. Again, this pitch and L, this one and this one, both should be in the same unit, multiplied by number of cuts. Threading cannot be done in one cut. It has to be done in a number of cuts. Here the speed at which the job is rotated is also lesser, so cutting speed will be lesser for thread cutting. It will be given S. Again, we will have to find out this N from this formula only. Here D, you remember, should be in meters, and this also in meters per minute. And number of cuts depends upon the material. If it is soft material, the number of cuts is generally 5. Soft material means copper, aluminium, like that. If it is steel, number of cuts will be 7. Number of cuts will be 5 for copper, aluminium, etc., softer materials. For steel, number of cuts will be generally taken as 7 for steel. Generally, we are given steel, the workpiece will be steel. Now, this over travel, if they have not given anything, if it is not given in the problem, you can take it as dia of the job divided by 2. Diameter of the job which we are doing divided by 2, half the diameter or radius of the job can be taken. So, for thread cutting, this is the formula. For all other operations, this is the formula. Now, we will do a couple of problems on this and finish it. If you have any doubts, you can always clarify them by calling me. My number is there on the video. You can call me. Now, there are no old question papers here. So, we have to do these problems from the question bank. We will take up from the question bank, we will take up these problems. There are many problems here. Of course, we cannot do all of them. We'll take up these problems. From here, the first problem that is given here is, estimate the time required to turn 3.5 centimeter dia bar to dimensions shown in figure. Cutting speed is, S is 15.4 meters per minute. 4 meters per minute. And feed is 1 mm per revolution. All cuts are 3.5 deep. Depth of cut is 3.5 mm. Now, the job, finished job, they have given a sketch. This is the sketch of the job, a simple job like this, to be done by turning This is 50 mm, 50. This is also 50. This is 50, this is 60. Here the dia is 21 millimeter. Here, there also it is 21 mm. Here it is 28 mm. 28 mm dia. 28 mm dia. And the workpiece is, the raw material is 3.5 centimeter dia. That is, it is something like this. This is the raw material given to us. From this, we have to remove these material, this excess material, and then we have to make it, to bring it to this size. Now, this is 3.5 centimeter or 35 mm. 35 mm dia. 35 mm dia. 3.5 centimeter is this. That means it is 35 mm. Now, first thing that we have to do is, we have to reduce the diameter of the entire length. Let us assume that the length, they have not given anything, we will assume the length of the finished job is same as the length of the raw material. So it is, the raw material is a 35 mm dia, and we have to first reduce that from 35 mm to 28 mm here. Throughout we will reduce it to 28 mm. So now first what I will do, number of cuts, number of cuts required to reduce the dia, to reduce the diameter from 35 mm to 28 mm will be equal to, this will be equal to capital D minus small d divided by 2 into depth of cut, depth of cut. So that is, final diameter is, initial diameter is 35, final diameter is 28, and depth of cut is given as 3.5 mm. So 35 minus 28 is 7 divided by, this is also 7, that is equal to 1. So it will be one cut, single cut. We can reduce the dia by, from 35 mm to 28 mm in single cut. So first T1, that is T1 is time required, time required to reduce the dia, to reduce the, reduce the dia of job, the dia of job from 35 mm to 28 mm in one cut, in one cut, over a length of, over a length of 160 mm, the entire length 160 millimeter will be equal to, this will be equal to, T1 will be equal to how much, L divide, L1 divided by F into N1, so many into 1, number of cuts is 1, so many minutes it will be. Now L1 is 160 mm, that is the entire length, 50 plus 60 plus 50, entire length. F is given 3.5 mm. This N is not given. So N1 will be equal to S divided by pi D1. S is cutting speed, that is 15.4. Now, because I have got this D1 35 mm, this will be pi into 35. So this also must be reduced to mm. So 15.4 into 1000 divided by pi into 35. So many RPM it will be. This I have got this formula from S is equal to pi d n. So n will be equal to S divided by pi d. Always the initial diameter must be taken for calculating the speed. Now using our calculator, let us see what we get. 15.4 multiplied by 1000 divided by pi divided by 35. I am getting 140 RPM. I have to rotate the job at 140 RPM. Then what I do, I will substitute this here. L1 is 160 mm, feed is 3.5 mm, feed per revolution is 3.5 mm, both are in mm, and speed of the job is 140 into 1, number of cuts is 1. So 160 divided by 3.5 divided by 140 will give me 0.32 something. I'll take it as 0.33 minutes. Next, what I have to do is, now the job has come to this level, fully it has come to this level. This has been removed, this excess material has been removed, and now this is to be removed here. Not here, here we don't need to remove it, here we have to remove this. Now here from 28 to 21, that also we have to remove 77 mm. 28 minus 21 is 7, 2 into 3.5 is 7, that can also be done in single cut. Here what we have to do is, so T2 is the time required to time, this is T2, sorry. T2, what is T2? Time required to reduce the diameter from 28 mm to 21 mm over a length of 100 mm. Now only 100, this 50, this 50 here, this 60 we don't need to remove. 100 mm in one cut or single cut. So T2 will be equal to L2 divided by F into N2. Now for N2 we have to same formula. For N2 what will happen is S will be same, because both are turning operations only. If it is different operation, plane turning only. Here if it is different operation, and if that, for that operation they have given another cutting speed, we have to use this. Here S is same, that is 15.4 into 1000 divided by pi into, now D2 will be 28 mm. You have to take 28 mm. Here you are reducing the diameter from 28 to 21. So initial dia will be taken, 15.4 into 1000 divided by pi divided by 28, that gives me 175 RPM. So this will be used here. So L2 is L2 is 100, F is same 3.5, multiplied by N2 is 175. Cut is, number of cuts is 1 only, so it will be 100 divided by 3.5 divided by 175. That will be 0.16 something. So we'll take it as 0.16 minutes. So the total time required to finish the job from the raw material to the job is T1 plus T2. T is equal to T1 plus T2. Total time required to finish the job is T1 plus T2. T1 we had got as 0.33 minute, plus this we are getting as 0.16 minute. So T will be equal to 0.48 minutes. This is how it is to be done. This is the way of solving this problem. I hope you have understood it. If there are any doubts, you can ask me by calling me. You can ask me. I am taking problem number 7 from the question bank. It says, estimate the time for threading on a 3 centimeter dia. I think it should be 3 centimeter dia. 3 centimeter dia, 3 centimeter dia aluminium bar of length 10 centimeters, length 10 centimeters by single point tool. If three threads per centimeter are to be cut and speed of the bar, that is N, is directly given here, is 80 rpm. N is given 80 rpm. Assume suitable approach and overrun and the number of cuts. So they have not given the excess travel. The tool has to travel. So we will take excess travel, over travel, that is on both sides, over travel as D by 2, that is 3 by 2, 3 centimeter dia it is, 1.5 centimeter as the over travel, and this number of cuts, because they have said it is aluminium rod, we can assume it as 5. Aluminium rod, they said, estimate the time for threading on a 3, it is printed as meter dia, it will not be meter, let us take it as 3 centimeter dia aluminium bar. So because it is aluminium, it is a soft material, I have taken the number of cuts as 5. Now T is equal to L plus over travel divided by pitch into N multiplied by number of cuts, so many minutes it will be. So L is 10, over travel is 1.5 divided by N is 80. This pitch is 3 threads per centimeter, means pitch will be 1/3. In one centimeter there should be 3 threads, that is 0.33 centimeter, 1 centimeter by 3 threads, so 0.33 centimeters into number of cuts is 5, so many minutes it will be. Now this works out to how much? 10 plus 1.5 means 11.5 divided by 0.33 divided by 80 equals, this is for one cut, 0.435 into 5, that will take roughly 2.2 minutes. This is the time taken for this particular job. 2.2 minutes is the time taken for finishing this job. Okay. This finishes it. If you have any problem, See, there are many problems here, but I will not be able to do most of them. So you will have to try out, and if there is any difficulty, you can ask me over phone. I shall be of help to you. Right.